And the host for today is Manbir Kaur. So over to you, Manbir.
Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing fine and safe. So this is Manbir Kaur and I'm the pilot for today's tour and we will be going to visit Germany. So do you know where Germany lies in the world map?
It lies in Europe, somewhere between France and there it lies.
Yes, definitely. So it lies in
Western Europe.
Yeah, it is the European country. All right. So excuse me for a while. There is a technical issue. Okay. So meanwhile, Prakhar, do you want to teach us some German words?
Okay. For basics, Wasser. Wasser means water. Bread. Bro means bread. Wine means wine. Beer means beer. There are different words. It's not really that easy to understand, but once you get the hang of pronouncing it, it's pretty easy to do it.
Yes, because you know, it is due to the different accents. So that is quite difficult for like...
Yes, the accent is quite different to what we are used to. So it's really hard for us to adapt to it in the beginning.
Yeah,
but definitely. Once we get the hang of it, it's good.
Yeah, so thank you, Prakhar. Thank you so much. Now we are proceeding with the presentation. So as you can see, the map area which is highlighted, this is basically Germany, which lies in the Europe. And you can see, can you tell me the different colors you can see the map of Germany?
Black, red and yellow.
Okay, so it is like somehow it is looking here like a yellow, but it is golden actually. Okay. So I'll tell you about that also. So first we'll look the map of the Germany. So here you can see the map of the Germany as well as the neighboring country. So you can spot Netherlands, let me mark it for, yeah. Okay, so you can see Netherlands, Belgium, Luxembourg and France. France, here it is. Then like in the southern area, it's Switzerland, Austria. Like Austria, we visited before, right? Then comes with Czech Republic.
And then Poland.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So that is all about the map and the neighboring country. Now talking about the map, which I told you earlier. So these three colors in the map are actually the black, red, and the gold. Okay, so talking about the area of this country. So this country is expanded over 348,560 kilometer squares. And even you can see a beautiful view of this country. Okay, so talking about the capital, so it's Berlin. Do you know which is the largest city in the Germany?
Not really sure.
It's Berlin itself. So Berlin is the capital as well as the largest city in Germany. And it is expanded over the area of 891.8 kilometer squares. So here I have shown the night view of a beautiful city. So we can see like how beautiful it looks like at the night.
Yes, ma'am. This is a sort of a video clip, isn't it?
It is actually the GIF.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah,
those are pretty useful.
Yes, definitely, because it gives you the live view.
Yeah.
Okay, so like we have talked about the German. Yeah, so the official language is German and Prakhar has already told us a few words. Okay, so other than the German, there are a few more languages which are spoken in this country. So such minority languages includes of Sorbian, which is spoken by 0.09% in the east part of the Germany. And the north region, it is spoken by around 10,000 people. And German, they speak in German as well. Okay, so... Okay.
So bald eagle.
Yeah, so bald eagle, it is a national animal of Germany.
Bald eagle?
Yeah.
It's golden eagle.
Okay, Okay.
Because bald eagles live in North America and not Europe.
All right. So Rohita told that this is the bald eagle. All right. Thank you for the correction, Rohita. Now, coming up to the national flower, so you can see how beautiful it looks like. So this is the cornflower. And yeah, it is like a little funny to speak, but it is really beautiful, no?
Completely beautiful. Weirdly beautiful.
All right. Okay, so now I'll tell you about the government. So Germany has a federal republic government, and the president, you can see, the president is Frank-Walter Steinmeier. Yeah, you can see his picture as well. And talking about the chancellor, it's Angela Merkel. Okay, so coming up with the population, so it's 83.29 million as per of 2021. The currency, you already know that all the European countries have the currency as in euro. Here you can see a live GF.
The population, ma'am, 89?
It's 83.29
million. Okay, ma'am.
All right. So here you can see the currency, that is euro, and you can see the live photograph as well of the 200 euro. Now, talking about the national sport. So football is really loved sport at this place. You know, like if I talk about the people living in this place, so more than 40 million people are involved in sports, specifically in the football itself. So they are really huge football fans.
Yes, ma'am. The German soccer team is also pretty good.
Yes, that is why. Because the people here, they have keen interest in this game. And even the audience as well.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so proceeding towards the climate condition of this place. So Germany is favored with generally temperate climate. So it has temperate and the marine with cold, cloudy winters and warm summers, that is like quite obvious. And like in the southern area, there is a little warm wind. Then the greater part of the Germany lies in the cool or the temperate climate zone, in which humid westerly winds are predominate. Okay, so now I'll tell you about some of the beautiful places to visit in Germany. So the first one is the Berlin's Brandenburg Gate.
Brandenburg Gate. It's pretty nice.
Yeah.
It's sort of like the it was in Greece.
Okay. All right. So
yeah, there was something Acropolis, I think.
All right. So coming up with the next destination, it is the cathedral. So it is a twin tower cathedral you can see over here, and it is it is very ancient cathedral to visit, and you can even see the architecture over here. Like it is very old, you can see.
Yes, ma'am, it's clearly visible. It's pretty old.
Yeah. And even it, so that is the reason it is fascinating as well to visit this place, because like people nowadays are really fascinated to see the old architectures, right?
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what happened.
Yeah. Now coming up to the natural beauty, the Black Forest. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, so this is a beautiful Black Forest with its dark, and like here you will see the densely wooded hills, and it is the most visited site over here in the Europe, like whole in the Europe. Yes.
A question.
Yes, Abir.
What all live in this apart from plants?
Like, as you can see, it is a Black Forest. So this place is like hugely covered with the like wildlife, as like Prakhar already told. And here you can see the houses as well. So people are living here. So yeah. Okay, so
this is a really nice place to stay. I mean, the greenery is just blinding.
Yeah, actually it is. Okay, so coming up with the next, it is the ultimate fairy castle. Although it is named as a fairy tale.
Neuschwanstein Castle. I know about this one.
Yeah. But it is mentioned as a fairy tale, but it is no more such a type of fairy tale.
Yeah, it was built by the so-called fairy tale king, King Ludwig, I believe, if I'm not wrong.
Okay, thanks for telling us, Prakha. So this is actually a sports center. So although it is named that, but right now it is the sports center and people usually a sports center as well as a resort. So you can stay here and you can play here and you can enjoy the beautiful view as well because it is covered in the greenery, mountain and water. Like a good amalgamation of the nature, I can say.
It's called the fairy tale castle because at that time it was built to be modeled after such stories that were told to the common people here.
Right. Thanks for adding the information, Prakhar. Okay, so now I'll take you to another beautiful destination of the Germany. So it is Miniature Wonderland and the historic port of Hamburg. Yeah. So it is the world's largest railway platform. It is expanded over the 12,000 meter long railway track.
It's a sort of a mini model.
Everywhere. Yes. You will really enjoy the window view, if you travel here. So they are very beautiful.
Yeah, it's an enjoyable place if you like seeing especially things that have a more artistic value.
Yes, definitely. Okay, so now I'll tell you about... Yes, Arhan?
In the last slide, there was the... near the bridge between... why in the between the bridge, there is a flag of Austria between...
It is a neighboring European country. So, while you travel to this place, now you discover this train goes to the Austria as well, because it is a rail. Here you can see the miniature, a miniature view. It is not the exact view.
You mean this is a railway station?
Yeah, this is a railway station.
Miniature model railway station. Yeah, not really a real train station, I believe. It's sort of like we build clay models of things. It's sort of like that, but on a higher level.
Yes. Okay, so now talking about the dishes the people of Germany eat. So German people really love to eat. They really love to eat meat and especially the roasted meat. And
including sausages and pork.
Their
common drinks are beer. Beer are offered to children at very young ages only.
Yes. Because traditionally they are consuming it, right? So that is the reason. In the Western countries, it is really okay because of the tradition of that particular country.
And then, I love sausages.
Okay, that's great.
Germany is known for football, bread and sausages, festivals and carnivals, cars and education.
Yeah, can you tell me the famous car brand from Germany?
I did not find that.
So have you heard about BMW?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I believe it's German.
Yeah, it is headquartered, that company is headquartered in Germany.
And 1/3 of Germany is still covered with forests and woodlands.
Yes. It's a very, green area.
Yeah, because as Romita told that 1/3 of the Germany is still covered with the forest.
Okay. Ma'am, I had one separate but related question.
Okay.
Will we be visiting Iceland?
Yeah, definitely.
It has one of the lowest crime rates in the world.
Okay. Alright. So now I'll tell you about the traditional dress of the Germany, and even you can see in this picture as well. So people
those
men...
suspenders.
Yeah, they wear short pants. and like and the women's wear a frock type dress. So I'll show here you. So the dress which usually men's wear, it is named as a lederhosen. Because it is made with the leather, so that is why it is named as a lederhosen. So all of the boys in this meeting, would you like to dress up in the Germany traditional dress? Do you like it?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
Come see. Okay.
Yeah. Not that much.
Okay.
The and pants are a little...
Yeah, because they wear short pants.
Didn't know why.
What do we wear usually in the house?
Yeah. It is actually the traditional dress. Like nowadays, nobody wears it casually. But this is the
in the women which wear, there is something strange in that. Why does this thing hold a flash?
I believe that's a bouquet just for attraction.
Yes.
This is your attractive.
Like both of the girls, you can see they have attached some flowers, right?
Yeah.
It is just like a presentation kind of thing of the traditional dress. So they might have thought to add flowers into their dress. So that
like we wear ties with our suits. Sort of like that, these guys have flowers along with their dresses. I believe they're wearing a corset, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
It was used in America in the 1980s to symbolize some sort of slavery, though. Nowadays, it's a fashion statement, but in earlier days, it was like that.
All right. Okay. So, as the dresses of the men's is named as a lederhosen, so similarly, the dress which women wear, it is named
That means leather trousers.
Yeah, leather trousers. These are not the trousers. These are the short pants. Leather pants. Like trouser is a different thing. It is up to the knee length. Ankle length.
Trousers right? are full length.
Yeah, they are full length. So, this is the traditional dress. So nobody wears it in the German nowadays. So, but in India, anything can happen. You know, as nowadays we can see the bell bottoms were used to be the traditional dresses, and now it is continuing the fashion, right? So.
Ma'am, I have one thing to say.
Yes.
Ma'am, imagine the family that took this photo. They were all gone for some family outing and they're now we have become famous all over the
world. Yeah. Like it could be anything. Like it could be like they have dressed up for the fashion dress competition. Like you can
or say. Or they have dressed up to celebrate some festival.
Yeah. But you know, these things should happen at least. Like the coming generation should know what is a traditional thing, right?
Yeah, that much should be known.
Yeah. So it is somehow very necessary as well. Okay, so now I'll tell you about the airline industry. So can somebody tell me the national airlines of Germany?
I don't know.
Lufthansa.
Yes, Abir, correct answer.
Air Germany.
Okay, so here you can see the logo.
I knew every country has... air than the country.
Air plus the name of the country. Air Germany.
Yeah, that is quite common. So but for the Germany, it is a little different. It is Lufthansa. And here you can see the logo. So can you tell me what can you see in this particular logo?
We can see...
It's a bird.
It's a sort of a bird that is soaring high.
Yeah.
That's what it's trying to symbolize.
Yes, so this is what the whole
and this upright position symbolizes that it's probably going for takeoff and it's probably not gonna just fall to ensure faith in passengers.
It is basically representing the air. So Lufthansa, this Lufthansa. Is the flag. Okay, it is a flag.
Lufthansa.
Okay, thanks for the correction. So this is the national flag carrier, and its secondary hub is based at the Munich Airport. Okay, so to add up on the sum of the facts, so it is the best world best airline in the world as of 2021.
So this year.
Yes, this year. So reason being, as we already know that in 2020, like pandemic really hit this world, right? So this airline was here to provide best services. Like traveling in this particular airline was like everything satisfactory, like the customer services and the, every services which includes of the any of the airlines while traveling. So it was very reliable.
Due to the pandemic, you'll be surprised to know that Israel is the only one country which is free from this pandemic.
Yes. It's free from masks particularly right now, but not exactly free from the entire pandemic. Yeah,
because the people of the entire country are vaccinated.
Not only vaccinated, they're also pretty
double vaccinated.
Yeah, yeah.
And plus they are disciplined.
Definitely it is.
India has this problem. The population is huge.
Following the rules also.
The problem with India is since the population is huge, there have to be lots of people who are, you know, going to go against the COVID guidelines, and they're definitely going to break the rules. Plus, people are acting pretty careless now and then. We don't even step downstairs and people are roaming around free of masks, playing around. I don't know what all they do.
When I also go down to play, I wear a mask and then play.
I don't even go downstairs to play. It's been 1 year.
Actually, all the things that I want to visit in India, I can do nothing but just wait at home thinking about it.
And that was why I go in the morning. Almost nobody is there.
Like, this is quite common situation with every one of us, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Unfortunate, so, but true.
Yeah, but we can't do anything of it.
Yeah. Stay home.
Stay safe. We are your mom.
Then we will be free of this pandemic.
Like it will take
this COVID. Since 2 years we are taking this.
Yes. And even everyone is now like, I can't say bored, but yeah, they are tired of this thing, right?
Yeah. Not me. I found a way to adjust my plane.
Yeah, but like from this pandemic, we have learned a lot of new things as well.
And Germany has many public holidays.
Yeah.
India has one of the most though.
Yeah. Okay, so that was all about my presentation. I hope you all have so enjoyed quick. Your Q2.
Mom, yeah. And in German, thanks means no.
Okay.
Thanks is donk.
All right.
Donk means thanks. Schuss means bye.
Okay.
And if you want to say goodbye, you can say Guten Schuss. Guten Schuss.
Guten Schuss.
And if you want to write, you can write it as well.
Yeah, I'll write it. I'll type it in the chat.
Yeah, that's great.
Prakar, if I'm not wrong, for good morning, it's Guten Morgen, right?
Yeah. Guten Morgen.
Yeah. So who wants to share the facts while Prakhar writes it in the chat box?
I?
Yes, Arhan, you can go.
Yes, ma'am. German is the official language of 5 countries, including Germany, Switzerland, Austria, Luxembourg, and Chile.
Luxembourg is also a particularly good French-speaking country.
Yes, and my father has also gone there. And Switzerland also. And Germany.
Alright, thanks for sharing.
And German is the third most commonly taught language in the world.
You know, weirdly enough, I have a lot of confusion between Japan and Germany.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Okay.
Why? Why do you have it, Abir? Because it's in totally different continents, right?
No. I don't know why it is, but some reason.
Yeah, even I have confusion between my G's and my J's. Happens.
Yes.
Even though I speak English very
well. Of wildlife also.
And do you
can I like the Rohita?
Yes, Rohita.
Ma'am, university is free for everyone, even non-Germans.
Yeah, that is what I was going to speak about. So if it is very reliable for the international students, like if the people from the other countries, they are fluent in speaking German, so they can apply for the scholarship. And like at the very, like they even don't have to pay the fees and you know, you can study in the German.
Mama in Germany hates France.
Not hates. Hate is too strong a word. It dislikes France.
And on the,
on the other hand, hates France.
And there are, I have one wildlife curvy. I have one person.
Germany also uses Latin alphabet.
Latin? Uses Latin also.
That's great to know. Arhan, you have something to say? Or
yes, ma'am. Only one about the wildlife.
Yeah, before
that European wildcat, it is with a long, thick,
can I tell a funny
broad head, have a comparatively flat face. The European wildcat has the wild core also. Has the.
Can I tell a funny fact?
Yes, yes.
In Germany, they make cake with Fanta.
Okay. That is quite strange.
Really?
Then you can say the cake might be Fantastic.
Who will eat that?
I think instead of milk, when they mix it, they use Fanta, I guess.
And that cake is sure to be fantastic.
Germany is also known for its long and rich history.
And
cake would be fantastic to make.
To Indians, Fanta making cake with Fanta will be disgusting for Indians.
Yes. Yeah. It depends on everyone's culture, right? It depends differently. What we like, others might not like the same thing, I guess.
65% of like dal rice, they must be not liking that.
Yeah, because every country has their own taste. So for others, it could be like quite strange. But for the native people, it is okay with them. So before ending, I would like to tell you that tomorrow we will be going over the quiz. So I have a small task for you all. So you have to come up with some amazing and funny facts of the quiz.
I have one last fact on Germany.
Yes, Prakar.
When John Kennedy came to Germany and visited Berlin, he said, "Ich bin ein Berliner," which translates to, "I am a jelly donut."
Okay. Okay, that's fine.
It seems like Greece is a very old country.
Greece only developed to the Olympics.
Yes, correct. So you can search many facts about Greece, actually, since it's a very old country, just like India. So we will meet tomorrow to know about Greece, okay? So it has a very,
tomorrow
very interesting
Greece fact. We are going tomorrow?
Yes, Greece. Yes, Arika? Yes, Arika?
What was the task for us?
To write some funny facts about Greece.
Funny facts about
me. If you have funny, that's great. Otherwise, also it's fine, because there are Greek mythology also, which is very very famous. If you want to know about it, you can search that also.
Mama, I know little words about Greek.
Really? Greek. So yes. Tomorrow we will ask you, Rohita, to say a few words and teach us.
And ma'am, the dinosaur word. Usually people say, from where did you get the word dinosaur? So they will say, from a Greek word named a terrible lizard. But that is wrong. The dinosaurs aren't terrible, neither lizards. The actual word from they got the word dinosaur is great, fully big.
Okay, that's an interesting fact. Okay, then, so let's meet tomorrow. So you will remember to write the facts, right? Even if it's funny or if it's not, it's okay. You can write it down.
Okay? I write down the facts every day.
Okay, that's great. That's good. That's good to know. Okay, then, we'll meet tomorrow. Bye.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you.